Week one of the playoffs is here. We're going to be taking a look at Blast Syndicates taking on Iridescent Dawn Frozen. Should be an action-packed one.
Yeah, I mean, Masuf does not quite have lethal here, but definitely wants to go for it. But
I think he's dead. Team fighting late game comp later on, as we're seeing some early dives coming across with the turn off of the turret with Masuf's ultimate. This dive's looking to go pretty well, but it's a triple knock of the mixture at an adaptable ape. Trades one back.
For Kami here, there's just no way that the Sivir can feasibly get up to this wave.
Kami now getting heralded by Kavable Cub. Flash for flash. Kami drags the tree all the way under the tier 2 turret. Glad I was at least right on one of the coals. Hello, here comes that old combo we're talking about. Between worlds into the darkness.
And Iridescent Dawn Frozen just don't seem to have a way past this. Big trades in the top lane.
Apple Ape likes his odds against Masuf. He's tired of the disrespect. Big heal comes across, but the bramble stacks for Adaptable Ape. This is not a weak side Ornn. This is a winning lane Ornn. We have an engage in the bot side as well on the hub pop for Kami, trying to speed up Ivan Godly. They're going to single out Bento, try and get that lethal tempo going. He's going to use that twisted advance to get four by Ivan Godly. Flashes for a headbutt, knockback, the alley sec. Will it get Kami to kill? One more swing of the axe. We'll find it. An eye on Kami, who is nearby. First one secured, going over to IDF. Flash committed, twisted advance going through, and there is the paranoia between worlds combo. It's Teals once again feeling like he's on Groundhog Day, dying the exact same way. Kami trying to turn the fight back with the Sivir damage, but not important. Able to kill off Ivan Godly. A lot of low health bars for Flash Syndicate. They'll have to give away the last two grubs, likely, unless there's a steal from coming across from Available Cup. Now Bento gonna re-engage onto Kami, who does spell shield at first, and now the turret's coming across. Joby trying to use the ultimate to set up Kami to carry through, has the barrier, has the damage to wipe out the fight.
Towers going down, very, very big for Iridescent Dawn. Who cares about the Herald when you can just take the entire tower?
That one grub allowed Masuf to get the first turret. Is very low in the trade with Adaptable Ape, but he's got friends this time. 3 versus 1, and the Ornn desperately trying to cover first turret gold is going to end up giving over a lot more gold.
At this point, Adaptable Ape is not going to have the opportunity to do much more, but who cares about that?
All right. Paranoia between worlds did not result in a kill this time. They're able to keep Teal safe. Ivan Godly re-engages to try to hold off the flank. Masuf understands that they're all cornered down here and tries to at least kill off not important. Adaptable Ape's gonna teleport in here just to guarantee nobody dies. This is an AD carry lesson for all you at home. Do not get in melee range of an Ornn, and Kami's learning the hard way, but unfortunately for Adaptable Ape, he runs out of cooldowns, runs out of distance as he gets further and further away from Kami, and he has to meet Joby in a 1v1. Adaptable Ape very strong. They're going to flashback forward. Big stun from Joby. Kami is still up and firing, stepping forward with no HP, and that is an easy shutdown for Bento to claim. Gives that gold over to IDF. Not important. Able to stay safe as well. It's only Bento in a precarious spot, but with the rest of the ranks showing up for Flash Syndicates, they're looking to push the tempo. Teals having to flash away as Terry. This is a classic wet noodle fight going on in the top side between two tanks with too many tanky items. Both use the ultimates to show they are really down to clown here. Somebody's going to drop, and it's looking like Adaptable Ape because Masuf just heals too damn much. Expecting a non-important ultimate somewhere, but we're not seeing it. Maybe just used to try and delay for that mid lane turret take, but there we finally found why, and it's Teals' sweet revenge
to really play the game. In the meantime, Masuf has been very much playing the PvE. Structures going down.
Has teleport available. Here is the paranoia between worlds combo once again, but this time it's on to Kami, and it lands a dagger into the hearts of IDF. They're going to teleport both top laners in, but how does the frozen comp look without their Sivir? Shadow surge through. Here comes Steels trying to get a big time fear. Masuf trying to mark a flank opponent. Does knock down, not important. Drops the Stormbringer onto the backside. Terry trying to kite back as well, and it looks like without the Sivir, IDF absolutely crumbles. Shutdown is going to come across as one fleeting kill for Masuf, but Terry is still untouched. How much healing can this Fallen Bear do? Masuf went from the early game doomer to nearly the late game bloomer.
Who cares about that previous fight? We're getting another one on top of it.
We're getting crazy in the Dragon Pit. Looks like not important was able to secure soul point for Flash Syndicates. It might have cost them. Kami's the only one to die, though. They still have five strong. Teleport coming in for Terry as well. Bento far too low, but there's the Between Worlds combination. One shutdown will come across. Terry is untouched, but Masu somehow earns a 1v1 with Terry off to the side, and Joby on this tanky feel the burn. Udyr is in a 1v2 of his own, but really ends up saving them in that one, as Flash Syndicates are just playing full momentum here. And we saw this in the early game, but this time with more damage in the kit, Teals just doesn't have a shot in the world.
Right, Triple Bro Fox is doing so much here, and Masuf not going to have much of a chance to do much.
Here comes Joby. He might not have vision, but he knows where the fight is happening. Masuf able to alleviate the first one versus four, and he goes in for the execute, just rips Terry to pieces. And now you've got Kami not beyond godly here. IDF find the fight turn that they need. There's no paranoia. There's no Between Worlds. There's no gas left in the tank for Flash Syndicate unless it's Conveyable Cub just throwing out rockets from off to the side. And now Joby has to think twice about re-engaging. Wave there and present. Kami wanted to step up. Flashes galore. Throws a big Q out. Doesn't find any of those kills, but they at least section off Adaptable. A
Hextech Soul, a huge boon to the team for Flash Syndicate. So the question is whether or not Iridescent Dawn can push this Baron to the limit.
Who's really playing the pick comp now? Antike is not important. Learned the hard way that it's IDF this time round to find that kill despite the paranoia going down. That turret already pretty low health. They should be able to just burn through the tier two. There's no point in indexing into a ton more damage because I need to be able to survive my engage. Speaking of engage, Dapple Abe, we talked about the Battle Orn. Battle Orn is one versus four. Lights are going to go out, but the Orn is down. Between Worlds drop through for Terry, trying to get on the back line. Immediately goes into stasis. They're trying to get to Cammy, but this time Cammy kites it out. Down goes Terry. I spoke too soon. Terry actually finds the trade kill. Masuf's trying to hold the other members at bay. Flashes to kill off Conveyable Cub, but he kites back to safety. Terry trying to step up as well. Excuse me, that is Teals trying to step up. It's Bento that has to relinquish position. And IDF, despite losing Cammy, are running wild in the Flash Syndicate's base.
For this game.
Here we go. Could be the game here on this fight with how late we're into it. It's another defensive paranoia from not important. Adaptable Ape looking for a big set of knockups, but he misses the Ornhorn. But Terry's damage with Conveyable Cub burns through at first, but it's the hero of the game, Masuf, to step up with an instant quadra kill. What a hero from 0-2, and he's looking to find a Penta in game number one. It's slowly taking time with Adaptable Ape having all tank items, but don't rest assured, here is your game one pentakill for Masuf to call game for Iridescent Dawn Frozen as he finally hunts it down and claims it.
Free here, but in the end, it is just going to be a matter of who comes out on top to begin with.
I, like many people, oh my god, I was looking on the left side of the screen, this lovely graphic, the right side, and that's the one way to punish Force 1v1 that he is going to be in advantage with. But seems like bottom lane is where the real story is coming across. We are forcing ults. Ibeon Godly really want to get Conveyable Cup out of the way. Will with the flash. Error going to come back through just to slow up the rel. As Joby and company with a new set of Chains of Corruption will lock down.
Lights out for the Nautilus. And that kill going to get traded back over to IDF. What the hell, Masu?
Cleaver to the face and a grass proc is more than enough for Masu to take over top lane. It's bot side. We have Bento's Revenge. Dives for Kami. The Ignite should find the kill. With Matt plays, who's gonna win this one? Spiraling Despair, slowing Adaptable Ape down, Severing Bolt. Hui's early game damage is enough with a cleaver to the back of the head from Adaptable Ape. Four versus two dive on the bot side. How many kills can they claim cleanly? There's a one for one. Turret aggro gonna be dropped in a good possession and reclaimed, so they only end up losing Terry. It's just Dive City in game number two. Terry looking to be the next victim. One charge of Spirit Rush, good seismic shove. Terry cannot use that key ultimate to get out. It's Teals to pick up the kill. Gets out of turret aggro just in the nick of time. Does Bento enough damage to try and trade out Teals? Not if he says, sayonara, sucker. Runs away, dodges out on enough damage and the arrow. Oh. But it's going to be a flash ball in the heal. Teals completely beats Inconveyable Cub. And purely for recognizing that with this Varus building the way he is, he can get cheaper items for more economy. Because we have a Weaver's Wall down, not important, cornered. Bento trying to play bodyguard. Joby not able to find the execute. Heartbreaker did have to be used over the wall in.
Coming in on that top side, this Mudo is surely in trouble.
Trying to heal as much as he can, but no maximum dosage, no death realm needed. I'm Beyond Godly going in with the full magnet crash down, and we have a jungler bout, one versus one, but the range prevailing for IDF, just like their comp demonstrated. Good flash from Kami to make sure that Adaptable Ape cannot find the Death Realm onto him. Bento trade out. Terry looking for an angle in, but you lost all your damage dealers. Your comp is in shreds, and Joby is looking to capitalize, going all in to secure the kill onto Adaptable Ape. Flashing the Champion Master, letting them know the Taliyah jungle is still potent.
5,000 gold up 20 minutes into the game, but it's looking very difficult for Flash Syndicates, but a step too far for the Rell.
Gifted a possession for Non-Important, looking to really chain these together. Joby, the next threat. Another one coming through for Non-Important. The root comes across, but not before the possession. He's going to Heartbreaker out to safety, but Non-Important himself just cashed in about 1,500 gold. And now he's got the rest of the team with him, but a piercing arrow from downtown, and Cammy sends him to a great screen. Adapt to leap, ult Masuf in the one versus one of the Death Realm. Trench Line going to land, though, on two teals. They have the way locked through. Shut down for Gable Cub. It's cashing at the bank day for Flash Syndicates, but it's going to cost them as Cammy is just sniper get downing with these piercing arrows to at least make sure the kills are traded. And Cammy's not even done just yet. Knows that Adaptable Ape and Conveyable Cub are far than low enough. That's three kills with three piercing arrows. But it's Adaptable Ape that seems to have the upper hand for now. Not enough health left on Masu. Flash over the crash down. The shield is so potent. Adaptable Ape has his kill. But now our next battle opponent steps up to bat. It's Adaptable Ape. It's going to get thrown into the walls with a seismic shove. And Joby,
because if your opponents have Mountain Soul, they're not taking much damage from your poke. If you have Mountain Soul, if your opponents get on top of you, then they can't really do much. But speaking of can't do much.
Okay, Adaptable Ape in his own 1v1 with Teals, but his team on the other side, how well can they hold up? It looks pretty darn well with Conveyable Cup staying safe. Throws an arrow onto Joby as well to lock him in place. And here comes the Flash Syndicates, but they fall a bit flat. The low health bars are enough, and Kami is running wild once more. Gravely hurting. All this a bit of a stall to allow Kami to step up and try to get a wave in. Does eat a charm to the face. Good flash, but the depth charge was already marked onto Kami. Joby nearly having to bail out. This time he will fall at 1 HP. Kami's still safe though, and that means the arrows are inevitable to ring through here. Commits a valuable flash and a dredge line. This is not your jungle anymore, Flash Syndicates. It is fully occupied by the territory known as IDF, and oh, they're gonna make sure you know it, as they are a couple autos, a couple hits onto the Nexus away from a 2-0 lead to move on in our Vanquisher League playoffs. Non-Important maybe looking for a gank able to try and shut down the Titan of game number one. The Taliyah is nearby, though the sweet spots are landing. Masoof's gonna commit the flash. Everybody just flashing in different directions, but Non-Important to find first blood. And Joby just doesn't have the damage or the time to really connect them onto Adaptable Ape. We have the Realm coming up from Teals. No flashes for either one of these Flash Syndicates players. It's the Flash Q, but the angle is not lined up.
That Dominus available is so, so unbelievably difficult for the Aatrox to deal with. And no World Ender available. No way out either.
Once again, Joby has the right idea. Had Bot Prow to play for that Dragon to make that easy trade, but wasn't there on the cards. We're seeing the roaming ability of this Poppy. There's the Demonic Ascension pop. They're trying to slow down Teals, who is flashless on this Vel'Koz. And they're just it looks like they just want to rinse and repeat here. Non-Important's coming over. World Ender popped. It looks like Masuf wants to go for the fight. Dominus traded as well. Both these very powerful ultimates, but Adaptable Ape is just far much stronger.
Yeah, Adaptable Ape now going to be able to pick up his first kill in the
Joby
matchup.
Man, Joby having to flash away, but he's still dead. To pick up Amir Gromp, gets him killed. Lien at 1 HP finds a kill. Bento gets the second one. Pace when they needed it most. Now we got flashing Masuf trying to at least find one kill back. Should be able to get it onto Adaptable Ape. The healing isn't enough. Waiting on a reset of that dash. The slow, though, across from Swain, and Adaptable Ape survives.
Respond to Flash Syndicate's top laner.
Joby's caught in his own jungle. It just gets worse and worse as this game is completely flipped on its head. Masuf finds a shutdown.
Remember, this is a six void grub team, meaning that two of the void mites spawning for Ziggs is going to be rough as hell.
Down comes Terry and not important. Bento used the Hex Gates to flash. It cancels the Weaver's Wall. Outplays Joby just trying to get out of the fight, and the never move makes sure that,
you know, the consistent force on the side of IDF to engage on them. Okay, who cares about Jage? Never mind.
Adaptable Ape is a force to be reckoned with. I think Leon's just opened up the base already. They're on inhibitors.
Leon did more than open up the base. I think they're going for the end. Hold on. This is literally the entire Nexus Tower getting attacked on. A teleport in as well.
No way.
And no
what
way.
What am I watching? This is 18 minutes in. They have Void Grubs. Did Flash City gets pushed too far? They're trying to burn down the last Nexus turret. The Nexus is open and exposed at 18 minutes. They're just going to try and hit through it, and Flash Syndicates are going to keep their series alive by getting the quickest win in Vanquisher League history. No, they are shut out. Because they had people clearing minion waves mid. We'll have time to talk about it. They're going for a pick onto Adaptable Ape with the Dragon burning on one side, and Jovi and Masuf have more than enough damage. Masuf is... They're going to leave Masuf to catch the waves, but once again, it looks like Flash Syndicates are trying to turn for a fight here, and they find the Dream Engage to just lock up everybody and put them into the meat grinder known as Demonic Ascension. Kami trying to kite back, but he's got a Renekton right on top of him. Masuf's teleport is far too late, as he's now found himself in a 1v4, and the smart heads up play from Leon, he knows, hold on, their last member just went for a fight. We're just going to teleport into their base. We've got three whole teleports, and Flash Syndicates in rapid succession found themselves a game win to keep the series alive 2-1.
And again,
Ungodly using his health bar very well, gets the root down, throws the ignite. One more dredge line should wrap up first blood. Ivy Ungodly grabs it with a barrier prop. Kami finds a second.
Had actively devoted resources towards making the spot lane work out, and oh lord.
Wow. Don't know how that gank fell so flat. Maybe trying to capitalize on the two low health bars. At least Bento will hook shot, and this is the consequence of forcing a vertical jungle, as Joby can play towards the top side as Kami is just starting to run away. This is all gas, no breaks in the bot side. That's a Kami double kill. This Sivir is 4-0.
This Sivir dominance here. Let's watch this one more time. As we can see, it was an invade onto the Gromp that just does not work out, as Kami just able to flash in, get not one, but two kills. Yeah, honestly, my thought is that they were like, all right, well, I mean, we have a Zyra. We know we can take, she can take jungle camps. We know that we have our jungler down here.
Kami did not account for the Sejuani in the brush. Burns the barrier without flash. Gifts a 580 gold shutdown over to Lien.
In the meantime, not important. Very, very much in there.
There's the CC chain. Not important, no hesitation.
Poor Kami here, but in the meantime,
God. Fancy feet, the dredge line is late, and Lien has rebounded miraculously. Everybody able to limp away, as we see off to the side of Adaptable Ape, making sure to make it costly. First turret's gonna go down. Somehow, it seems that Teal ended up 1v4 on Lissandra. Now it's teleports galore coming through. Kami trying to kite back. Bento assassinated. Flashback from Kami. Able to stay away from not important. Here comes Dapple Ape trying to force the issue with Masu. There's a Spiral and Despair down. Doesn't do enough damage. Terry is out of mana. Does not have the health to contest. Not important as well. Just trying to stand tall. But there's a big lock and shield. Ivy Ungodly stays safe. Hookshot forces the flash away from Terry. And now it's time to just get rid of the rest of these kills.
Fine. As long as we've got the three to start, you can't get any Void Mutts here on, it's okay. Lien, on the other hand, getting quite a lot of damage off.
Re-engages self, utilizes the Frozen Tumor, open to dodge the Strangle Thorns.
And says, all right, I like your comfort pick. I raise you one of my own. Here's kind of a soul we have for us.
Masuf doesn't want to back up. He wants to go in and make sure to punish Bento and Lien, who did not calculate for another well-timed teal flank.
Instead, it's just going to turn into another opportunity to dive here. Hold on.
Apple Ape, 1v4. Gets Ivy Ungodly far too low, and they get a re-engage with Unborn in the end nearby. IDF really forcing the issue, and it's starting to hurt them. Maybe not.
Kami on the back.
Where's Kami? How the hell did he get all the way back there? Finds the shutdown on Terry, and Masuf is able to free hit Lien past the two tanks on the team, and that just lines up for the Camille and Lissandra to run wild. Dapple Ape flashing away from the passive from Teals. Hexagon's Maiden wasn't even used, and now Bento's feeling the pain of it. Locked between two parts of his wall, they hesitate to give the kill, and that actually gives a shutdown to Bento. Masuf in the enemy base still wants all the smoke onto a down lane. We'll get it with the Q2, but he'll die now to a turret. This is a bloodbath. Not important engages on Sejuani to priority targets, but most of the time just kind of taking what the enemy teams will give them. With this Zyra being able to hold a lot of people in place, you can see the Stranglethorns gets a four-man knockup right there, allows Nonborn to sneak out. We're forcing self-Lissandra ultimates. Teal's just trying to get the heals. Dabble Leaf going forward, get the all-out. They've got Masuf, and now Cammy is cornered around three. Sure, they lose in the end on the side, but they come out ahead in the main advantage, and there's no damage dealers left up except Teals, who tries to dive for a trade onto Bento, the support.
Entirety of Flash Syndicate's out, but oh, here Cammy. Comes the hunt.
Ops on the hunt, gets away from the Stranglethorn's knockup, but Adaption Ape has a flank and they lock Cammy in place. Adaptable Ape has him marked. Cammy desperately trying to kite back away from the tanks, but the all out executes him. In goes Teals, trying to find a big engage to get one kill back. Uses the Frozen Tomb. Masuf teleporting in. He's going to have to be the hero because Teals is dead. Adaptable Ape finds that kill and Masuf is diving for the back line. But can he find any of these kills? The roots, the stairs, they're enough for the turn, and Adaptable Ape holds the rest of IDF in place. But instead they back off, fearing the 5v5. Yeah, the wave might have done it because IDF is just running down mid lane, trying to threaten this inhibitor turret. They should get that at the very least. We gotta be careful about overstaying because Nonborn is gonna re-engage. They go in, try and lock down Teals. Cammy kiting back. Teals is gonna be the sacrificial lamb. How many kills can Flash Syndicates get here? Because they get enough, they have a Baron waiting for them, and they have Cammy locked up once again, just front to backing seamlessly, and they're gonna cash in one, two, make it a third on the kills killing spree. Jhin is a very slow Baron taking AD carry. Down to 3k, Masuf's gonna go in, wants Bento, picks up that first kill easily. Baron down, way below, spike to secure it. Ivy on Godly in the face, trying to hold everybody in place, but Terry's damage is just far too much greater.
Teals does not have a flank available to them. It is just going to be the solid front to back 5v5.
Masuf able to get out of the curtain calls by another ult use to not find any kills. The jockey positions off this Baron. Teals goes in, executes the Hui with Cammy's help, and then Frozen Tombs himself. Teals with a hero play. The Mighty just flipped the script of game four and won the series for IDF. They pick up four kills in an instant. Adaptable Ape gonna be that fourth one as Cammy finds the execute.
As the Lissandra that made the big game-changing, series-defining play is going to join the rest of the team in taking down the towers, in taking down Flash Syndicates, in taking the step to the finals of play.